Okay, so now you can use Microsoft Stream to do a live event. So you can broadcast yourself in real time and other people can view it from your organization. So I've gone to the Microsoft Stream main website right now, and I'm a Microsoft 365 user, so I can access it. And then other people in your organization can see it as well. There are settings to control who sees it, but right now we're just going to focus on how to broadcast this event. So we'll left click on live event, and then you get this starting screen here that's asking for some details. And the first thing it wants to know before you start is the name of the event. So we're going to act like we're going to announce a new location for our company, right? And you can also do a thumbnail. So I just made one up here. And Midwest, that's where we're locating. I'm not a graphic designer, okay? The video language, let's just leave that as English. And you can specify a time for the event, or you can say as soon as the encoder is connected. So yeah, you may want to schedule this for 11 o'clock on a Thursday, right? But just for purposes of this demo, we're going to say as soon as it's connected. And then the next area that you can control is the permissions. So if you just want to broadcast this, say, to a branch that may be moving to the Midwest or maybe being split up, you would specify that. Maybe they're set up as a group, or you can broadcast this to a particular channel that you have set up in Stream or specific people. So we'll leave this how it is right now. And if we look at the options, you can put a people timeline on it. So that'll generate a timeline of the different people talking in the video once it processes the video. So that won't show up for a little bit. And you can allow people to comment on it, and you can allow auto-generated captions. So those will be pretty accurate, but not perfect. So if you want this video to be around for a long time and have accurate captions, you'll want to go back and check those. Now let's left click on save right now. And now let's go back to details. So now it needs some information on the actual encoder that you're going to use. When I was setting this up, I downloaded Wirecast S, but I wasn't able to get it to work when you just use this preset, but I was able to get it to work when you configure it manually. So let's do that. It's not very hard. And this is what's called the server ingest URL. This is what we're going to paste into Wirecast S. First we want to start the setup. So now Microsoft Stream is thinking about what it's going to do, and you have to wait for it to be done before you start to broadcast. And now it says ready to connect. So now that it says that, we'll come to Wirecast S. Ignore what I have in the background there. That's the screen recorder of making this video about making videos. And let's just use this template here. We'll say presentation. We'll click next. And then it asks you some questions about your sources, right? So if this is going to do a presentation, it might be wanting to project your screen. Mine happens to be name this. I'm only using one screen. But if you have more than one, be sure that you capture the right one. And when you are broadcasting live, it would actually be nice to have more than one screen because you could use one for your content and then the other one for your kind of control room where you would leave something like Wirecast S up and running. But regardless, I have one, so we'll leave it there. You have to tell it what your camera is and what your microphone is. So if you have an external microphone like I do, be sure that you have it selected. Otherwise, it's going to pick up your internal mic and your audio won't sound as good. I have mine disabled, so it can't accidentally pick that up. But be careful with that setting. If you have an external camera, same thing. Let's left click on next. You'll see the main interface of Wirecast, and you get this weird infinity mirror action that happens here because it's recording itself, recording itself, recording. Yeah, you get it. So this will go away as soon as you have what you're presenting in the foreground. And let's talk about what this is looking at right now. So they're in layers. And if you come and look, the camera is first, then the screen, then the microphone. So to configure any of these, let's first switch our view. So in the upper right-hand corner, right now we're looking at what it looks like live. Let's look at a preview. And then when I select the camera layer, for example, you can see there's a frame around the camera here. and then you can change the settings. I have my webcam too low, right? Let's do that. You probably don't want a giant microphone in front of you, but I'm assuming you don't. And you can do some things too, like if you double click on the camera, you'll get a control panel on the left-hand side. Shouldn't dig too deep into these because we're probably not doing how to use Wirecast, we're doing how to use Stream. But let me do one thing, and that's to key out the green screen. It's not doing a very good job of it right now, it's all fuzzy. Maybe I can change some of that. There we go. That's just to show if you want to be on top of your screen. So I do this in my videos where it's that way you can see the content, and maybe you don't want to show what's in the background in your room. You can green screen out, but you need an actual green screen to do that. And you can also just control your camera a little bit where you can kind of crop out the sides. All right, so let's say this is what we want to project. And remember, this background is going to be your presentation, right? But right now it's showing Wirecast because that's what I have maximized on the screen. If I had two monitors, I would move this off to the side, but you also wouldn't be able to see the video of making the video if I had two monitors. It's saying ready to connect because you're not streaming yet, so you're not sending anything to Stream, but it's ready. So what you need to do, because you have this on configure manually, copy this URL. So I just left clicked on copy. We'll go over to Wirecast and we'll select output, output settings. Destination is Microsoft Stream, but in the address you need to change this. Maybe you can get it to work without changing this, but I wasn't able to. Click OK. And then you want to start the stream. So left click on stream. And let's watch Microsoft Stream on the right. So instead of ready to connect, now it says you're ready to go live. And it needs a little bit to catch up because there's this lag, right? I'm taking Wirecast, I'm sending it out to the web, then it's coming back to Stream the way we have it set up right now. But then there you go. So your users aren't going to know there's a lag because they're not watching you live, they're watching this. And you can take Stream and switch it to the audience view. The audience view is this on the right hand side because you haven't started your event yet. So they're still seeing the thumbnail. Let's start the event. So it just takes a little bit and then they're going to be seeing. Remember what's over here in Wirecast. And here we go. So remember, I have audience view selected. So this in the upper right hand corner is what they're seeing. And it still looks weird right now because it's my screen where I'm actually just recording this video. So you would go to your presentation and you would maximize it. They would be seeing this and they would be seeing your camera if you had that on. And that's how to stream in Microsoft Stream. So let's talk about what happens afterward. Let's say we went through this event, you made your awesome announcement and you clicked end. And they're just saying, hey, once you end it, you can't restart it. This is a one-time thing. So let's still end it. And then it has to do some thinking here and it's processing the video. And then afterwards, it's going to be in your content. But first, it's asking, do you want to trim it? Let's say yes, because you might want to trim it because you just think that the announcement in the middle is important. You might have had some, I don't know, idle chit chat in the beginning. And maybe at the end, you took some questions that you don't want saved. So let's just say we're going to trim this. Left click on apply. And it's saying you're permanently going to lose the beginning and the end if you trim them. That's fine with me. We'll say continue. And it's just telling you that it's working on your video, but it's already here. So this is the recorded version that you're seeing afterward. So if you go to my content and left click on videos, this video is going to be in your catalog, right? And you can change some settings on it now after it's done, but you've already broadcast it. And this is just saved here as another video in Microsoft Stream. So next up, we're just going to talk about how to use Microsoft Stream itself to record your screen. So that's a lot more simple, and that would be to record a video that you're just going to post to Stream later. So it doesn't have the encoding software involved in it. And I'll see you in that video. Thanks.